The MP Claudia Webbe is facing a potential jail sentence and demands to stand down from her seat after being found guilty of a campaign of harassment, including threatening an acid attack. Now, Webbe is the independent MP for Leicester East, elected as a Labour candidate in 2019, was accused of harassing Michelle Merritt, a friend of her partner, with threatening phone calls. At trial, she was accused of using derogatory terms concerning Merritt, threatening to use acid and saying she would distribute naked pictures of her to her family. Following the verdict and a warning from the judge she could face a prison term, Labour called for Webbe to quit her seat and trigger a by-election. Webbe has protested her innocence and made clear she plans to continue as an MP, but what term might she be looking at? As often is the case at times like this, we turn to Joseph Kotrie-Monson, who's criminal defence lawyer at the firm Mary Monson Solicitors, to be found on Fleet Street. Joining me now, what sentencing might we be looking at after this verdict? Good morning.
Well, good morning, Nick.
Morning, Joseph.
This is a case which is serious enough to warrant a very short custodial sentence, but equally a harassment case such as this in the Magistrates Court, usually dealt with by way of community order. Now, this is an offence which causes harm but not violence, and a low-level offence that she was charged with that can only be heard in the Magistrates Court. Now, with regard to sentence, Nick, courts take into account both aggravating features, which increase seriousness and sentence, and mitigating features, which make community orders more likely. And the aggravating features here are obvious. Sustained calls on 18 different occasions, the fear of violence that you point to because of a threat, and the vulnerability of a victim who is being threatened with the release of compromising photographs. But there is also mitigation here, and it's substantial. Mrs. Webbe has likely no previous convictions. She is also a public servant, as we're aware, of many years standing. And there is the tragedy, of course, of this that's ending her professional life. And fundamentally, one might expect, Nick, that a tribunal would have some sympathy for the circumstances of a woman phoning somebody that she at least believed to be the lover of her husband. Now, where do the scales fall, Nick? We don't really know, do we? District Judge Goldspring has given Mrs. Webbe, as you point out, that warning about the possibility of custody. But, Nick, judges nearly always do that, even if they intend a community order, because it increases the suffering in the interim and it's part of the punishment. Professionally, I'd be a little surprised, Nick, if she received a custodial sentence. But, you know, as we say, the Magistrates Court, it can be an unpredictable place.
Fascinating summation. Thank you, Joseph Kotrie-Monson, as ever. Criminal defence lawyer at the firm Mary Monson Solicitors on Fleet Street. Sentencing takes place on November 4th.